If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification.
Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in basic level where we are solving questions on parabola from Tribhuvan University previous year question papers. So today we'll be solving question number 3 and 4, two questions. Okay, then let's solve this question. Now if you come to question number 3, the chord passes through the focus of the parabola this and intersect the parabola at x1, y1, so that this. So again a chord passes through the focus of the parabola. So if you take the focus a comma 0, it is y square equal to 4ax. They have given. If they don't give, you take y square equal to 4x. If they give, you have to take that one. Because it is given, so you will take this one only. Intersect the parabola at x1, y1 and x2, y2, it will be. Kindly again correct it in the question. So it cut at x1, y1, it cut at x2, y2. So same type of question is solved in question number 1, almost same type. So that something of this fashion. So again, what you will take, suppose this is P, this is Q. So let P, which is your x1, y1, they have given, is equal to P. In place of x1, we will write it in T1 format, AT1 square, 2AT1. Because it is easy to write it in parametric format. And Q, which is your x2, y2, will be taken as Q, AT2 square, comma 2AT2. Then it's easy, we have seen. So equation of PQ, what is the equation of PQ? I am writing from directly. Now from the number 1, this was the equation of PQ. You can do it in the exam. So that was the equation of PQ. This was the equation of PQ. You take how I have solved it, same question. If you apply, this one will come. So it will be y minus 2AT1 is equal to 2 by T1 plus T2 x minus AT1 square. Again, same condition, it passes through f, that is a comma 0. So if you put it a comma 0, so it will be, so again I am writing it, but I will not solve it. You can easily solve it by seeing the same. So if you solve it, you will find t1 t2 is equal to minus 1. This is a standard one, but you cannot use here because it is subjective question, you have to write it. Okay. So once you know this one, so what will be your x1 is equal to a t1 square. What will be your x2? Because t2 is also minus 1 by t1. What will be x2? A by t1 square. What will be y1? 2a t1. What will be y2? In place of t2, I am writing minus 1 by t1. So now you show that what they are asking, x1, x2. Therefore, x1 into x2 is equal to, if you take product of these two, what will be this one? t1 square, t1 square will be gone, x square. So this is proof. And what they are asking to prove? Another one is this one, y1, y2 plus 4x1, x2. So if we put it there, 2a t1 into minus 2a by t1 plus 4 into a t1 square into a by t1 square. So this will cancel, this will get cancelled. It is minus 4a square plus 4a square is equal to 0. So proved. This side is also proved, this side is both are proved. Now if you come to question number 4, find the equation of the parabola whose focus is given. So they have given you a focus which is 3,4. Let it be 3,4 focus. And a directrix which is 3x minus plus 4y, 3x plus 4y plus 25 equal to 0. So if you draw it, both will be negative. Something of this fashion directrix is given. So something sort of this type of parabola it will come. So because P is xy, so they have given both this formula. So this length and this length are equal. So you know PF. So the equation of the parabola will come, we know, the length, the distance from the focus of the point on the parabola is equal to length of perpendicular to directrix from P. So this length. So P, what is PF? It is x minus 3 whole square, y minus 4 whole square should be equal to, you have to find the distance from this, using from the point x comma y. So if it is, if you put xy, so it will remain same. So it will be 3x plus 4y plus 25 by under root 3 square plus 4 square. So if you take square both sides, so it will be x square minus 6x plus 9 plus y square minus 8y plus 16 is equal to, here it will be 25, it will be 9x square plus 16y square plus 25 square is 625 plus 2xy by 12, then it is 200y, then it is 150x. So if you now side change, it will be 25x square, 25y square, left is 60. 25x squared, then 60, that will be 150x minus 200y, and it's 25 into 25, 625, and this is same, whatever it is. So 625 will get cancelled. So 9x squared, it will be 16x squared, then 25 minus 16, it is 9y squared, then minus 24xy, then 150 minus 300x, then y 200 minus 400y is equal to 0.
If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.